Hello, I'm Dr. Dave Stone, a toxicologist at Oregon State University. I'm also part of OSU's Superfund research program, where we study a group of chemicals called polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, or PAHs. PAHs are everywhere, and they present some important issues for your health. In this video, I'll address 5 questions about PAHs. What are they? Where do they come from? How are we exposed to them? What are their health effects? And finally, what can we do to reduce our exposure to them? Let's begin with what are PAHs. Polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons is a mouthful, so I'll keep referring to them as PAHs. Basically, they are a large group of chemical compounds that contain carbon as well as other elements. The basic structure of a PAH has 2 or more rings. They range from the relatively simple compound naphthalene to much larger and more complicated compounds like benzoapyrene. There are hundreds of different PAHs, but we only have good information on just a few of them. We can find PAHs in air, soil, water, and sediment deposited from wind, water, or ice. They are released from several natural and man-made sources, which we'll discuss later. Most PAHs do not dissolve easily in water, so they remain in water when they are released through industrial and municipal discharge, particularly from stormwater. PAHs in the air can be present as either vapors or stuck to small particles. They tend to travel long distances before they drop back into the ground. Once they are deposited into soils or water, microorganisms are the primary way in which PAHs break down in the environment. So, where do PAHs come from? PAHs are formed when organic material containing carbon is burned, which means there are lots of both man-made and natural sources that can generate PAHs. In the natural environment, PAHs are formed during forest and grassland fires, as well as during volcanic eruptions. PAH compounds can be found within the smoke, as well as attached to heavier particles. PAHs are also found in natural deposits of crude oil and coal. Man-made sources of PAHs are also numerous. They are generated when we burn fossil fuels, such as diesel, during the oil refinery process, and when we burn garbage or incinerate medical and industrial waste. PAHs are also formed when we grill food, which is especially important to me since I love to grill. In these examples, PAHs are formed accidentally. However, PAHs are also used intentionally in some products as well. We use naphthalene in mothballs to repel pests and as a solvent or intermediary in many industrial applications. Coal tar also contains PAHs and is used as a sealant for streets and parking lots as well as in some roofing materials. Well, what about the third question? How are we exposed to PAHs? We can be exposed to something by 3 major ways: through ingesting it, by contact with the skin, or by breathing it in. For PAHs, all of these exposure sources can be relevant. One of our most significant exposure pathways for PAHs is our diet, and eating foods cooked in certain ways, most notably through grilling. When food, particularly meats with high fat content, is charred or blackened during grilling, it forms PAHs as well as other harmful compounds. Breathing in PAHs can be an issue for both the public as well as for workers in some jobs. At home, a significant source of exposure can occur through wood-fired stoves used for heating, particularly older stoves that are not efficient or have inadequate ventilation. Smoking creates lots of combustion byproducts, including PAHs. These not only harm smokers, but others nearby, particularly kids and people with respiratory issues. Burning candles or incense also generates PAHs. Keeping homes and other buildings free from indoor pollutants, such as PAHs, is important. Outside of the home, PAHs are also found in the air we breathe, usually at low levels. Urban air generally has higher levels of PAHs compared to rural areas, particularly urban areas near construction sites, rail lines, highways, and ports, since PAHs are produced by vehicles that rely on fossil fuels. Well, what are the health effects of PAHs? We have long known that PAHs can be harmful to our health. In fact, one of the first links between cancer and certain jobs involved PAHs. Back in the 1700s, young boys were employed as chimney sweeps in London because of their small size that allowed them to fit inside the chimneys. An alert physician named Percival Pott began to notice that an unusual number of these boys had developed scrotal cancer, and he correctly observed that the cancers were a result of skin exposure from all the soot. We now know that the soot is full of PAHs. But what about breathing PAHs? Studies on workers have shown that increased lung cancer in certain jobs, such as coke oven or roofers, using cobalt-based tar materials. Cigarette smokers were also at much greater risk of developing lung cancer. Beyond cancer, many of the same inhalation exposures can result in negative effects on breathing, chest pain and irritation, frequency of cough, and throat irritation. Ingesting PAHs is still the biggest exposure pathway for the non-smoking public. There are only a handful of studies that looked at human health related to consuming PAHs in the diet. However, we know from animal studies that high levels of PAHs in the diet have been associated with several types of cancer, reproductive effects, and problems with the immune system. So finally, how can we reduce our exposure to PAHs? Fortunately, there are some relatively easy things you can do on a personal level to reduce your exposure. Pay close attention to how you cook your meat. If you grill or charbroil your food, it doesn't take long or much skill in the kitchen to remove the blackened portions of your meat. If you can adjust your grill or smoker to increase the distance between your flame and the meat, it may take longer to cook, but it should be less charred. If you heat your home using a wood-fired stove, consider having an energy audit to determine if you have an efficient stove and that it ventilates properly. Some cities and counties even offer credits to replace old wood stoves with more efficient models. Eliminating or reducing candles or incense in the home will help with indoor quality as well. If you smoke, there are several options and programs to help you quit. And even if you don't smoke, it's important to keep tobacco smoke outside of the home and cars, particularly if young kids are involved. Ask your smoking friends or family to smoke outside as well. In summary, PAHs are complex chemicals that are produced by both man-made and natural sources when organic materials are burned. Cancer is the greatest health concern, but not the only one. Smoking, wood heating, and grilling or charring meats are our greatest exposures to PAHs. Thankfully, we can take steps to prevent or reduce our exposure to PAHs. You've already started by learning more about them and why they matter. Again, this is Dr. Dave Stone, and thanks for watching our video on PAHs. This video was brought to you by Oregon State University's Superfund Research Program, funded by the National Institute of Environmental Health Sciences, grant number P42ES016465.